Welcome back to another video here on my YouTube channel. I'm SeantaMarie and I'm a lifestyle vlogger here on the tube. I thank you guys so much for tuning in, and if you're new, make sure you hit the subscribe button so you can continue to see more videos like this one. I just try to show you guys the things that happen in my life in hopes that it'll help you in some way, shape, or form. So let's go ahead and jump in to how to pass your PT test in a very, very quick manner, like if you're in a time crunch or whatever. So I had a PT test recently and I was literally given a week's notice that I was going to be taking it. Now I work out all the time. I am an avid lifter. I go to the gym. If you check out my other videos on here, you'll see that I'm participating in Summer Shredding with Christian Guzman and the whole Alpha Elite situation. I really try to show fitness on my channel because it is such a big part of my life. I try to eat healthy. I try to do all of these things, but at the end of the day, I am not good at the PT test, to be completely honest. I mean, let's not get it twisted. I'm gonna pass. I will never not pass because I will, I mean, they'd literally have to kill me if I, before I ever just didn't pass. But I've never failed a PT test since I have actually been in the guard. Definitely do not do as much cardio as I need to do. So the three areas of the PT test are obviously the 2 mile run, the push-ups, and the sit-ups. So to help you to be able to pass the 2 mile run, I highly recommend getting out and running. And by getting out and running, I don't just mean like, okay, let's get out, go run 5 miles, whatever, do what you do and you'll pass. No, you need to be switching the game up. So the biggest way that you're going to improve on your run time is to make sure that you are doing sort of like HIIT training when you are running. So I would say sprint as fast as you can for 30 to 40 seconds. And then you're going to want to jog for a minute. I would say if you're not even in that good of shape, then you can walk for a minute to a minute and a half, but it's going to help you to improve if you can sprint as fast and as hard as you can and then jog, let your heart rate get back down, and once that minute to minute and a half is up, then you're gonna wanna sprint again. You wanna make sure that you're doing that repetition at least 8 times. The most that I would ever do is 12. So keep doing that and that's going to help you improve your run. Now, you do wanna incorporate long runs into your fitness routine. So every so often I like to do a 30 minute long run. I actually have the Nike Plus running app, I think is what it's called, and they have guided running things on there. They have a long run that's really nice. They incorporate meditation into it. So you basically just wanna have a day where you're not running for time or anything, but you're just getting out there and just running. It helps your body to really focus on maybe if you're running incorrectly, or maybe if there's something that hurts when you run, you can focus and hone in on what that is so that you can try to correct it when you have to take your PT test. So that is my tips on the run portion. Let's move on to push-ups and sit-ups. Now, push-ups and sit-ups are muscle memory. So my biggest tip is to make sure that you are just doing as many as humanly possible. You are going to hurt yourself in the long run if you get to your PT test and then are just like, let me max out my push-ups and sit-ups, or try to. By the time you get to your 2 mile run, you're going to be exhausted, especially if you're like me and your sit-ups basically use your hip flexor muscles. So for the push-ups, I recommend elevating your feet. Now, if you're incapable of doing that, it's too difficult, then I would say to just do push-ups until you cannot do them anymore. Then drop down and do the female push-ups, because at least then your body is muscle memory going through the motions. So If you can, put your feet up on like the side of your couch. Well, something to get your feet up in the air, that is going to help you because you're doing your push-ups at a different angle. Now, if you're not able to improve from that point and it's not really doing anything for you, then you can try to do other things like adjusting how wide your arms are on your push-ups. And I can do a whole nother video on something like that. Thumbs up if you would like to see that. But the main thing is it's muscle memory and you need to make sure that you're doing push-ups. What I like to do, and my little secret, I guess, is if I'm watching TV or listening to a podcast, every single time there's a commercial, I drop down and do push-ups. I try to do as many as I can in 1 minute. So if I can make it through at least half of how many I have to do to pass the test in that 1 minute, then that's accomplishing something. Try to strive for better every single time that you do something like that. So moving on to the setups portion, it is a very similar situation. Setups are totally different. My biggest tip is to make sure that you are not using any muscles on the down portion of the sit-up. So a lot of people use all their muscles to come up, and then when they go back down slowly using their muscles to get back down. We ain't about that life here. You literally want to use whatever you gotta use to get yourself up, but when you get up there, throw yourself down on the ground. I can honestly tell you when I went to basic training, we had to do setups on a track like with gravel, and I had bruises all over my back because I threw myself back so hard when I was doing it. I ended up doing 82 setups in 2 minutes, the most I've ever done. So throwing yourself back, it just allows you to not use any more muscle than you need to. You want to use the muscle to get up, they're going to count you on the down. So throw yourself down, get back up. I also, when I'm taking the PT test, I also like to make sure that I do at least half in the first minute and then take a 10 second break at the top and put myself back down. That's just always what I have done, and I usually do more than what the mat, or I usually do more than what is required of me, so I don't feel bad doing that. Now, if you're struggling and you can barely get to making it through that to pass, then definitely don't take breaks. You wanna work on your stamina. So I practice by doing the same thing on commercial breaks. I do as many setups as I can. I also like to practice doing setups with my feet held by someone or held underneath of a sofa or whatever, alongside of doing setups without anyone holding them. Now, without anyone holding your feet, when you do that, make sure you are still putting your hands behind your head. Those are my tips and tricks for passing your PT test in a short period of time. Like I said, I found out about my PT test 1 week out before it happened. I hadn't done any running and I hadn't done any sit-ups in a very long time, and I still was able to do well over the amount that is required for me. I recommend using these tips even if you are someone who is struggling to pass your PT test. It is only going to help you in the end until you get in the swing of things. Just remember, muscle memory, and it's mind over matter. If you sit there and tell yourself that you can't, then that's all you're going to do. If you say you can't, then you can't. You need to make sure you're telling yourself, I can pass this, I can pass this, I can do better, I can do better. Tell yourself what you want and you can achieve it. So thank you guys so much for tuning into this video. I appreciate you guys so much. I thank you to everyone who is new, who has come to my channel. It means the world to me. Your guys' comments are so sweet. As always, if you have questions, hit me up on any of my social networking sites that are linked down below. And if you are an OG follower, I appreciate you so much. You guys have no idea how good it makes me feel to know that I am helping you guys out in some way, shape, or form. And I don't even know how to explain it. There is so much content coming to my channel in the near future. Make sure you guys tune in, turn on notifications if that's something that you like to do. And I will catch you guys in my next video. Oh, And if there's something that you want to see military related, leave it in the bottom. I have somewhat of an idea of something that I'd like to do. I don't know if that's something that you guys would like to do. So leave me comments of what you would like to see military related or on this channel, and I will be sure to record and get as much up as possible. So thank you guys so much for watching. I love you, and I will see you in my next video. Bye guys.
Tomorrow.
I hope it's off to drill. We go. We gotta do our hair and pack our bag. I hope.
I'm about to do my hair. So I guess I'll show you guys that. I think I have a video on my YouTube channel of how I do it, but it's drastically changed because your girl don't have time for the games. Typically I wash it at night, and then I just have this squirty bottle with water in it, and I use an actual like sock bun thing that you purchase from Walmart or Target. I need a new one. Like, it started to come apart, so it's fishnetty. But it just holds my hair really well. Like, I don't have to worry about the actual bun part coming out with this. But for the longest time, I actually used a sock, like one of my dress socks from my dress blue uniform. But now that my hair is long, that don't work. I gotta buy like the real ones or buy bigger socks to suffice. So this actually falls within the regs. If you guys don't know, your bun can actually only, like right now, it can only be 3 inches off the back of your head, which no one like adheres to that at all. And mine is actually in regs, so that's nice. I'm gonna just let you guys watch. So there are actually like so many different ways that I do my hair. There's so many different ways that I actually do my hair because I don't wash my hair. Oh my god, I can't. I do not wash my hair every day. So it gets done different like every single day. We just got Starbucks. I don't understand what the thing is now with Starbucks and the whole like not mixing up your drink thing. It's considered cross-contamination or something. I don't really know, but it really sucks for people who get freaking matcha like in their tea because it leaves chunks. So then I'm stuck stirring and I'm like, but this drink was $5 and you can't tell me that you couldn't stir it for me. It's so annoying.
Hey, wait. I make sure that Northside
eat. What are you doing?
I grabbed the wrong shorts.
I cannot.
It's coming. It's gonna work.
Oh my gosh. We're getting ready to go do PT. At what time?
You know, if you run fast enough.
At 10. We're about to die.
Turn, 2, 3, 1.
where am I going to start at?
This is a fried baby. It's a burrito.
Huh?
Chimichanga with beef. Shredded beef.
Shredded beef, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-mm, I'm more of a ground beef guy.
That's very white of you.
That's racist.
I'm just saying.
Well, you're not half. You're like...
He's like, hi.
Hello.
I'm Alex.
My name is Magugu.
The video for my summer shredding entry. I'm about to go to the gym.